Lupus to me is more than a disease to cure or heal. For me, it's become the reason to evolve as a human being in ways I never thought possible, but now necessary. To come to this realization, I had to explore the tactics on how to get well. In desperation, I first tried everything holistic to help my body heal. I was so scared, and this feeling drove my actions to avoid being in danger, the very danger that was within me, the lupus. Now I know that all the things that I can do to help my body heal are just tactics. While such tactics were helpful, the most important thing was my mindset. Most of us live our lives completely unaware of our unconscious system that drives our behavior. The concept of motivation triad was written by Leslie and Goldhammer, their authors. It explains that human behavior is driven by the motivation to seek pleasure, avoid pain, and to do what's easiest and most efficient. And that's the way our brain rolls. And this explains why so many of us get stuck living our lives by default. For many, even with the lupus diagnoses, we go on living exactly the same way while adding more medical interventions. We don't question anything because it's easier and much more convenient to let the doctors figure out what they do or what to do for us. But in order to get well, we must do the exact opposite of what the motivation triad tells us to do. Lupus Rebel embraces seeking discomfort. Go towards pain by learning to feel rather than avoid, and do the hard work of going against our own programming by deliberately changing our behavior. Nothing about Lupus Rebel healing is convenient, pleasurable, or easy. So I met with a lot of resistance from most of you. But let me talk a little bit about mindset as being the key. We have the most amazing computer system at our disposal called the brain. Problem is that most of us don't know how to use it to its full capacity. It was programmed from birth and it knows how to be efficient, so much so that it follows habitual pathways for just about everything that you do. It knows to seek pleasure, avoid pain, and be efficient. It's the limbic brain or the lower brain that can operate without much thought. For example, it knows how to get us to walk without thinking about the walking, right? It doesn't tell us to put the right foot forward and left foot to sway your hips or anything. We just know how to walk. It knows the route to get to work every day, so much so that when you drive, you don't have to look at the navigation every day to figure out how to get there. It's already programmed. The foods that you eat are also programmed in your brain. For breakfast, lunch, dinner, and even snacks. If you write down all the foods you eat each day and what time, you'll find that most of the foods you eat are the same, day in and day out. And the times that you get hungry are probably the same. The urges, the desires, and feelings around food are also habitual. I'm asking you for thought disruption so you can rewire and reprogram yourself to produce a different result. Lupus was a thought disruption for me as well because I thought I was always a health nut, but look what happened. So I was required to change everything I knew and everything I was doing. And I'm confident that I can help you to transform your life with lupus. But I know that you've got to want it bad enough to go through the discomfort. I'll be there every step of the way and go through it with you. But it requires you to think, feel, and act differently to drastically change the outcome of your disease. It's that simple. I'm living it every day. And while it was hard in the beginning, it was so worth it to empower myself and live my life on my terms. I know this path is not for everyone, but only a few that can handle the hard work. So let me talk to you a little bit about the success strategy. I want to share a success strategy that I learned from Dan Sullivan, who's a business coach. In order to succeed, he says, at anything, there are four things that are required. Number one is commitment. Commitment to see through whatever you seek to accomplish. Second is the courage. You've got to muster up courage to show up, willing to do the work. And it's not something that's innate in all of us. Three is capability. As you show up to do the work, you begin to learn the skill set that's required. And four is confidence. Confidence is not an innate thing that you're born with. It's developed through continued action and showing up every day. So to have confidence in your ability to handle lupus, no matter how bad it gets, is what we're accomplishing or aim to accomplish. I'm asking that you evolve beyond your current state of being. This requires having a different operating system, which requires you to change your beliefs about yourself and lupus. So, let me talk to you a little bit about the hierarchy of needs. I have a deep psychology background, and according to Abraham Maslow, a renowned psychologist, humans have a hierarchy of needs that dictate our behavior. At the base, we've got physical needs, then safety needs, and love and belonging needs, and esteem needs, and self-actualization needs at the top. He theorized that we have basic needs like physical and safety needs such as food, water, rest, security, and safety. Then we have psychological needs of love and belonging. For example, the need to have intimate relationships and esteem needs like accomplishment and prestige, like going to school and getting certified. But at the highest level, we have self-actualization, which is achieving one's highest potential, including the creative endeavors. I'm asking that we seek to evolve into self-actualization. You'll have resistance and pushback because your limbic brain, which has learned pleasure, fear, and efficiency, wants to keep you exactly where you are, even if that place is not serving you. Your brain thinks keeping you where you are is the safest thing to do. It will box you in and keep you from progressing because it doesn't know where it will lead. This is the natural way it's designed to think. But in order to understand yourself and your tendencies, you'll need guidance from me to push through the psychological barriers to get to the other side. And because I too struggled with this and was able to push through to create my life on my terms, I want to help you to get through such barriers. All the other tactics, such as functional medicine, acupuncture, nutrition therapy, supplements, then become just that, just tactics. But unless you change your operating system or your thinking to commit, have courage, create capability, and then increase confidence as a normal part of your life, nothing will change. That's why I've created the Lupus Healing Revolution, to help you through the mental barriers first and foremost in changing your mindset. It'll require willingness to study yourself, ask hard questions, learn to defeat fear, and push beyond what you thought possible. We're about to change what you thought was impossible to I'm possible. Are you in? We're launching the program at the start of 2020, and I am so excited that we're taking enrollment soon. Want to learn more? Sign up for our webinar where I'll teach you 3 secrets to successfully living with lupus. Register now, click below to commit and make 2020 the year that you live your best life ever. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please subscribe to our newsletter on lupusrebel.com, our YouTube channel, Dr. Connie Jian, and our podcast, Health Made Easy, on iTunes. Also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest at Lupus Rebel. Talk to you guys soon.